With the popularity of pedal shifted gearboxes making their way into professional and semi-professional levels of motorsport these days, we're seeing more and more aftermarket ECUs with the capability of controlling closed loop gear shift control using pedals without the driver needing to use the clutch pedal. We took the opportunity recently to head to Highland Motorsport Park and do some track testing to fine tune the gear shift control on a MoTeC M150 fitted to a Toyota 86 rally car equipped with a SprintX supercharger. With any pedal shift system, there's a lot going on in a very, very short time frame, so it's really important to log all of the parameters so we can see exactly what's going on later on the side of the track or in the pits. In particular on the upshift, the computer is receiving a signal from the shift pedal that the driver is controlling. This then signals the ECU that a shift has been requested, and in turn the ECU cuts the ignition to unload the dogs inside the gearbox and allow the next gear to be selected. Once the next gear is detected to be selected, the ECU re-engages engine power and it becomes a seamless upshift that's barely detectable. The downshift's a little bit more involved, however, as the ECU needs to auto-blip the drive-by-wire throttle body in order to rev match as the gearbox changes down through the gears. Let's have a look at some data and see exactly what's going on. At the top of the screen, we can see the purple line, which shows our engine RPM. Directly below this, we can see our throttle position. Now the orange line shows what the driver's foot pedal's doing, and the green line shows what the actual throttle body position's doing. So through this section here, you can see that the foot position and the throttle body position are both wide open. We can see our engine RPM rising, peaking, and then dropping away as a shift is requested. And if we look at our next group down, we can see our actual gear position. So you can see through this particular section of the log file, we start in second gear, move into third, fourth, and then finally fifth gear. The whole time this is happening, the driver is able to stay at wide open throttle. Now let's look at the next section here where the driver's now under brake. So under braking, we're going to be changing down a gear, and we can see the green blip represents here where the ECU has blipped the drive-by-wire throttle in order to rev match as we've moved. In this case, we can see from fifth gear down to fourth gear. Now when we get everything right, this results in a perfectly smooth, seamless shift that's almost imperceptible to the driver. And one of the key inputs that the ECU uses with the closed loop gear shift control is the gearbox position sensor. And what it's doing is it's looking at the current gear as well as the next gear, and we can see the change in gearbox position voltage as we go, in this case, from fifth gear down into fourth. And the ECU knows exactly when the next gear is properly selected, and this is part of the closed loop control of the MoTeC paddle shift system. If you're interested in EFI tuning and you want to learn more about some of the advanced functions that modern ECUs can control, check out our free 6-part series of tuning lessons. Click the link to sign up.